Now, this is the view right now out of the window. However, I was really hoping this morning. I was wishing as hard as I could last night. I thought, before I go to bed, I'm going to wish that we have snow. Unfortunately, this is not what we had this morning. So that is what I was hoping for. But sadly, this is what we got. Unfortunately, I'm ever so sorry about that. I was really hoping that we would get some snow, but no snow today, I'm afraid. Anyway, we are all here together again. Yes, at least there is a nice, happy consolation, even though we've had no snow. Yes, we are here once more. It is English Addict coming to you live from the birthplace of English, which just happens to be England. Are we on? Are we on? Are we broadcasting now? I hope so. Here we are once again. Yes. Hi. Hi, everybody. Hello. This is Mr. Duncan in England. How are you today? Are you okay? I hope so. Are you happy? Are you feeling good today? I hope you are. My voice is suffering today because, well, let me just tell you what happened. I was drinking some water and I was drinking it very fast, and unfortunately I started choking on the water. So you know what it's like when something goes down your throat too quickly. It can make you choke. So that's what happened a few moments ago. Some very dramatic scenes taking place here in the studio. So I'm here again. Yes, for those who don't know who I am, maybe you are flicking around YouTube wondering what to do with your Sunday. Well, my name is Duncan. I talk about the English language. I've been doing this for ever such a long time. Do you know how long I've been doing this for? Over 14 years on YouTube. I have been here since YouTube was still wet. You know when you paint something and the paint stays wet for a very long time? Well, I've been on YouTube since the logo for YouTube was still wet. They had just finished painting it. You see, so that's how long I've been here on YouTube. Not a very funny joke, but at least I tried. What? I know what you're saying out there at the moment. I know what you're saying, and I'm pretty sure Mr. Steve will be saying something later on as well. Yes, I know what you're thinking out there right now. So we've made it to the end of another week, and also the end of another weekend. I hope your weekend has been super duper. Yes, it's Sunday. Yes, we are here again. We have made it all the way to Sunday. Sunday, it is the 6th of December. Yes, we are now into the final month of the year. Are you excited? For many people, December is an exciting time because Christmas is on its way. I'm not going to do anything connected with Christmas today. However, next week I might mention Christmas, and I also might show you the lights on the house next Sunday. So not today. I think it's a little bit too early to get too excited about Christmas. But next Sunday, yes, I think we will start to do a little bit of celebrating as Christmas approaches. Even if you don't celebrate Christmas, even if you don't observe it at all, you can still have a little bit of fun next Sunday as we prepare to say hello to Christmas 2020. Talking of which, here is something Christmassy. So I said I wasn't going to show anything to do with Christmas, but this is something I saw the other day on the internet, and this might be my most favourite thing of Christmas 2020. Take a look at this. Can you see that? So there is Santa Claus. Look, there is Father Christmas, and he is carrying all of his, well, it looks like hand sanitizer and disinfectant wipes and all sorts of things. And also, oh, look, Santa is also wearing his mask as well. He's wearing his face mask. So I think that's brilliant. That's a brilliant gift for someone this Christmas, because, well, I suppose it helps to remind us all, even during this festive period, that we should all be staying safe and healthy. I suppose it's true. So that's my favourite thing so far this Christmas. I saw it the other day on the internet. Oh, another question for you. What is one of the most hottest, and when I say hot, I mean popular, what is the most popular or one of the most popular gifts that people are buying this year for their friends and relatives? Do you know? We will be talking all about that a little bit later on. Also, we have the mystery object today. I thought we would have something to get you to scratch your head and maybe make your brain heat up to a lovely warm temperature. So that's another thing we are doing today. We have the sentence game coming up. We are also taking a look at food idioms. I know that there are many idioms in the English language, and I get many requests asking, Mr. Duncan, can you please talk all about idioms? So today we're going to have a look at some idioms connected with food. As you know, you don't need me to tell you that food is one of my all-time favourite subjects. Last night, Mr. Steve made the most amazing meal. He made his famous cauliflower cheese once more last night, and it was absolutely delicious, along with some potatoes, some peas, and we had a delicious lamb shank. Apologies to any lambs watching at the moment. But yes, we had a lovely lamb shank last night. Very nice. We also have the live chat. Oh, hello, live chat. Yes, it is working. I'm just making sure that we have the live chat. Yes, the live chat is now up and running. Oh, my poor throat. I can't begin to tell you how much I was panicking. A few moments ago, I was choking on my water. Not very nice, to be honest. Oh, now this is a very interesting kettle of fish. Very interesting. Tomek, guess what? You are first on today's live chat. Hello to you and congratulations. Congratulations to Tomek. You are first on today's live chat. Nice to see you. We also have Vitas. Vitas is one of our moderators here on the live stream. We also have Thomas. Hello, Thomas, watching in the Czech Republic. Nice to see you here as well. Belarusia. Hello to you, Belarusia. Also Mohsen. Oh, hello, Mohsen. Can I say a big thank you to Mohsen, who sent me a lovely photograph of him watching me on YouTube. So here is the picture. I will put it on the screen right now. There it is. So there is Mohsen watching me on his, I think that is it a Game Boy? I know someone is going to say, Mr. Duncan, how old are you? It's not a Game Boy. But what is it then? I think it's Nintendo. Is it a Nintendo Game Boy? Or is it one of those new Nintendo Switches? Because there is another one called Switch, isn't there? That you can split up and play with other people in the room. So, yes, is this a Nintendo Split or is it just a Nintendo Game Boy? Or maybe it's neither of those things, maybe. I don't know. I don't play computer games, as you know. So there is me. And I was doing a special live stream on Friday from my living room. And I was wearing my Christmas jumper. I thought I would wear something bright and cheerful on Friday. So thank you very much, Mohsen, for sending me a photograph of you watching me on your computer console. That was very confusing, by the way. But of course, if you are watching me now, you are watching me watching you watching me on your computer console. Dear, I think my brain is starting to melt. So if you have a photograph of you watching me on your computer device, maybe on your mobile phone or your tablet device, or maybe on your computer console, ooh, very fancy, or maybe on your television. Some people like to get comfortable when they're watching me. They like to put me on their TV. I'm not sure. I always feel a little worried, you see, because there are people watching on their very large televisions, and I'm just wondering what my big face looks like on your television. So if you are watching me now on your television, maybe you are sitting down on your sofa or your couch watching me in a very comfortable position. What do I look like? Do I look okay? Is my face big enough for you? I hope so. Hello, Jose. Hello also. We have, oh, Versha. Hello, Versha. Nice to see you here today. Christina. Also, Sanjarbek. Hello, Sanjarbek. Nice to see you here as well. Yes, we have the sentence game. We have food idioms. We have the mystery object, which I will be showing you in a few moments. And I suppose also we will be having a look at maybe one of my lessons. Yes, for those who are wondering, I do have a lot of video lessons on my YouTube channel. And I suppose because I do my live streams, it might be very easy to forget that I actually have lots of recorded lessons as well. So whilst you are watching this, underneath this video, so underneath here, there is a whole list of all of my lessons, all of my English lessons. So the list is under this video. If you are watching on your computer device, maybe you can go down and have a look at the list underneath in the description. So all of my video lessons are available. And yes, I have made many video lessons over the years. We might have a look at one of those a little bit later on. I did mention Mr. Steve a few moments ago. Steve has once again been very busy in the garden. Let's have a look. There is Mr. Steve this morning. Now, as I mentioned at the start of today's lesson, we did not have any snow. I was hoping that we would have a little bit of snow, but sadly, no snow today, unfortunately. But there is Mr. Steve busy in the garden. I don't know what he's doing. I'm sure later on he will explain what he's exactly doing. What exactly is Mr. Steve up to on his little ladder? It looks like he's cutting something. But what? We will find out a little bit later on when Mr. Steve joins us in around about 10 minutes from now. My goodness. Mr. Steve will be here in the studio. So what about you? Are you getting ready for Christmas? I know not everyone celebrates Christmas. I am aware of that. But what about you? If you are preparing your, maybe, your decorations in your house, Have you put your tree up? Have you? Is your Christmas tree up in the house yet? Now, to be honest with you, I haven't put mine up yet because I've been so busy over the past few days. But next week, I'm going to put my Christmas tree up. The lights are already on the front of the house, and we will have a close look at those later on. And also, what was Mr. Steve up to this morning in the garden? I have no idea what he was doing. Can I say hello to... Oh, hello, Theo. Hello to the community and also Mr. Duncan as well. Duncan, how are you? I was not here for a long time. Hello, Fiden. Fiden Niden. Nice to see you here as well. Even if you haven't been here for a long time, you are always welcome to return. No problem. Emin is here. Also, we have... Yes, we have Luis Mendez. Luis Mendez is here again. Hello, Luis. Nice to see you here as well. Maria, how is the weather in your country? In Italy, it has been raining. Yes, I saw it. I saw it on the news. They've been talking about some of the atrocious weather. Atrocious. So if something is atrocious, it means it's terrible. It's awful. A terrible event. A situation that is very hard to bear. Something that is atrocious. Something awful. Bad. Terrible. So yes, I have seen some of the pictures from Central Europe. A lot of rain has been falling. We've had a lot of rain here, but not as much as you in Italy. So there is a lot of bad weather sweeping across at the moment, across Europe, Central Europe. Hello, Mr. Duncan. This morning, my region changed colours from red to orange. I'm not quite sure what that means. Does it refer to... I don't know. I'm not quite sure, actually. Maybe it refers to the virus, perhaps. I'm not sure. Perhaps you could give me the information. Gemini! Hello, Mr. Duncan. May I ask you a question? What are they talking about when they talk about Scotch egg? I know it has been a big matter in the UK. Scotch egg, it's a type of food, but it's a combination of more than one thing. It is an egg, a boiled egg, and then it's covered with meat. And then on the outside, they put breadcrumbs. And the whole thing is then heated up. So you have this lovely egg inside a ball of meat. And then on the outside, there are breadcrumbs. There is something on the outside to give it a little bit of flavour. Sometimes they are quite spicy. So a Scotch egg is an egg that is inside a ball of meat. And a lot of people this week have been debating whether or not a Scotch egg is actually food. Is it a meal or is it a snack? You see? Scotch egg. I might show one later if I have time. I might try and find a photograph of a Scotch egg to show you. Okay. Is that okay? I don't have one here, unfortunately. But yes, a Scotch egg. Now, personally... From my own point of view, I think it is not a meal. I think a Scotch egg is a snack. It is something you can eat very quickly. Scotch egg. Have you ever seen a Scotch egg? So now you know, Gemini. A lot of people have been arguing about that word. Hello to... Oh, I see. I'm losing my voice today because I was choking before I came on. I was drinking my water too quickly. Hello, Maria. Orange, red and yellow are the colours that classify the seriousness of the situation amongst the Italian regions concerning coronavirus. Now I know. Thank you very much for letting me know. So is it more serious now or is it less serious? So the place in which I live at the moment is moderate. So here we have moderate, the moderate level of caution. So that means that the shops can open, but we all have to be very careful where we go and how close we get to each other. Hello, Reynaldo. Hello, Reynaldo Antonio. Hello, Mr. Duncan. Here in Rio de Janeiro, our Christmas is celebrated with the full tropical summer. That is a very strange situation, actually, because I'm used to spending my Christmas in the cold weather, you see. So during the cold weather, during the winter months, when everything is chilly and frozen, we have Christmas. So we always associate Christmas with snow. However, if you are in a warm country, you have the very strange situation of actually having tropical Christmases. Now, I've actually had a tropical Christmas. Many years ago, I was actually in Malaysia during the Christmas festivities. So I actually did experience for myself a tropical Christmas. So I know exactly what it feels like. And for me, being English, it felt very strange. Christmas Day in the hot sunshine, eating turkey. Hello, Valeria. Nice to see you here today. Mr. Steve will be with us in a few moments. As I said, sentence game, mystery object. We will also be talking about Christmas gifts. What is one of the hottest Christmas gifts that people are giving to each other this year? I wonder if you can guess what it is. And yes, we have Mr. Steve coming a little bit later on. I am sure Steve will have some sarcastic comments to make about my appearance. I think so. I think he will be. Anyway, before Mr. Steve arrives, we are now going to take a look at one of my English lessons. Here is an excerpt from a lesson I made 11 years ago. I can't believe it. I made that lesson 11 years ago. In fact, it's the lesson that we are about to watch an excerpt from right now, all about today's subject. Later on, we will be talking about food idioms. So let's have a look at one of my lessons all about food. And then it's Mr. Steve.
Hi, everybody. This is Mr. Duncan in England. How?
Mr. Duncan. Mr. Duncan. Mr. Duncan.
Oh, hello, Mr. Lomax. How are you? What's the problem?
Mr. Duncan, I'm hungry. Can I have something to eat, please?
Of course you can. What would you like to eat?
I would like a big juicy banana, if that's okay.
Banana, eh? Let me see. I've got a banana around here. There's one. One juicy banana. There you go. Is that okay for you?
Thank you very much.
Bon appetit. Now then, where was I? Oh yes. Hi everybody, this is Mr. Duncan in England. How are you today? Are you okay? I hope so. Are you happy? I hope so. In today's lesson, we will look at a common item which is for each of us an important part of our daily life and our means of survival. Today, we will talk about food.
It's scrumptious, bumptious, tasty and sweet. It's delicious, nutritious, lots of fun to eat. You can have it hot, you can have it cold. It's easy to munch and it's easy to hold. You can eat it from a plate, you can spoon it from a dish. It's the greatest thing that you can ever wish. It's food, tasty food, scrumptious food, yummy food. It's food.
There are many natural elements contained within food, such as calcium, chromium, cobalt, copper, iron, sodium, and zinc. It is worth noting that these are present in very tiny amounts, which is lucky for us because the human body only requires a very small daily amount to function properly. Keeping the balance of these elements right is very important, as too much of them is just as bad as too little. Then there is protein, which helps the body to function and stay well maintained. Protein is made up of small organic chemicals called amino acids. These are absorbed from food during digestion and are used to create new proteins and other useful substances that the body requires. Finally, let us not forget one of the most important intakes that the body requires in order to function and survive. Water. Around 60% of your body is made up of water. The water in your body keeps you cool. It helps to keep the joints of your bones soft and supple. It carries nutrients to your tiny skin cells, and it helps to carry away all of the waste and toxins which would otherwise build up and cause you to become ill. Water is being constantly used and lost by the body through sweating and going to the toilet. Needless to say, you must drink plenty of water every day. Meals and food have different names depending on their size, when they are eaten, and where they are served. Hamburgers and other similar food is easy to make and serve, so it is called convenience food or fast food. McDonald's, KFC and Burger King are all classed as fast food restaurants. A quick small meal is called a snack or a bite. A meal where you select and serve your own food is called a buffet. A large meal served to many people in a hall is called a banquet. Here's a good question. Is milk a food or a drink? I would let you find out the answer to that one. Remember, milk and cheese contains lots of calcium, and calcium is good for your bones. Ah, delicious. There are many ways of expressing hunger. I feel hungry. I'm starving. I'm famished. I'm ravenous. I've got to eat soon, or I will faint. My stomach is telling me to eat. Wow, I really have to eat something. I'm so hungry, I could eat a horse. Cooking food has become a very popular activity for many people, and these days there are lots of cookery programs on television presented by celebrity chefs, although some of them do tend to be quite rude and impolite, such as this guy.
welcome to Go Cook Yourself. I'm Dave Nasty, and I'm a chef, and I'm rude to people. If you don't like that, then you can go cook yourself. This is a potato. I like chopping them up into little pieces and then boiling them in water. Then I mash them with butter. It's called mashed potatoes. Can you mash up potatoes? I guess you can't, because you're not a chef like me. I hate everyone. I'm Dave Nasty, saying go cook yourself. Goodbye.
I hope you enjoyed that. One of my old English lessons from many, many years ago. All about food made in 2009, 11 years ago. Can you believe it? I don't believe it. What are you doing, Mr. Duncan?
That looks very silly.
I'm showing the world my lovely smile.
I wish you'd show it to me. Hello, everyone. Hello. Oof. And nice to be here again on this, well, I was going to say sunny Sunday, but it's not. It's murky, murky. So it's misty and cloudy and dark.
Grey.
And grey.
Grey.
In fact, the fog is descending, Mr. Duncan.
You know what I was hoping for, Steve? I wanted to wake up this morning. I felt a bit disappointed, actually. I woke up this morning and I was hoping that outside the window I would see this, you see. I was hoping to see this today.
Well, it would have been very nice. It would have been very nice because we wanted to do some filming, didn't we, Mr. Duncan? We wanted to create a nice snowscape, a nice wintry scene for something that we might be showing later on towards Christmas.
Yes, I didn't want to say anything about that. That was a real secret there.
Well, if you hadn't drawn attention to it, it would have just passed and nobody would have noticed. But so, yes, we were hoping for that. When was this filmed, Mr. Duncan?
This was, this must be a couple of years ago. It was the last time we had lots of snow. Look at that. Isn't that lovely?
We didn't have any last year, did we?
We didn't have any snow. It was a very unusual winter, very wet, but no snow. So that was what I was hoping we would see waking up this morning. Sadly, sadly not.
Hello, no. Again. Hello, Mr. Duncan.
Oh, would you like, would you like some applause, Mr. Steve?
Would be nice.
who was that kiss for?
It's a secret. I'm not going to say, Mr. Duncan.
I see.
Well, interesting you should show your DVD video there, Mr. Duncan. How many years ago did you film that about food, Mr. Duncan? How many years ago did you film it? Move on.
My DVD?
Yes, well, that's what it was.
It's not a DVD. Okay,
it's a video there.
Just video.
When did you film that? How long ago? I mean, it looked like it was years ago.
Well, it was years ago.
How long ago?
11 years.
11 years?
Yes.
11 years. Well, Gemini 2 says, hello, Gemini 2. Talking of food, what's all this talk about Scotch eggs? In the UK at the moment, everyone's talking about Scotch eggs. And you are correct. It's been on the news a lot this past week. So well done for watching the UK news. And do we know, Mr. Duncan, isn't it Boris Johnson who's been talking about Scotch eggs?
Yeah. My computer has just gone wrong.
Has it?
Before we go any further. Oh, dear. I don't know what's happened there. We've become frozen in time.
Well, it wouldn't be for the first time, would it, Mr. Duncan?
Let me just see if I can... Oh, dear. Something's gone very wrong.
I haven't touched any of your buttons, Mr Duncan.
No, I didn't say you had.
I've done absolutely nothing. You can't blame me for this.
I don't know what's going on here.
Malfunction. Oh,
this is very interesting. Let me just see if I can work out how to put this right.
Well, while you're doing that, I'll carry on talking about Scotch eggs, shall I?
Yes.
So that you can concentrate.
Okay, let me just see if I can put this right. If I can, I will be... Oh, dear. Oh, no, that's definitely not right. Something has gone.
I wonder what people can see. Can you... people are saying that they can see us. Duncan's computer has gone crazy. Well, of course, it's the shock of seeing me. Even the computer can't cope with seeing such beauty and manliness.
I have no idea what's happened here.
Can you hear us still?
Yes, I think we're going out in audio, but I don't know what's going on.
I've never... Your camera's turned itself off, Mr.
No, it hasn't. It hasn't, Steve. No, the camera's still working because there we are still. We're still there, but we're... I don't know how... Can I just show you what's happening at the moment? Look at this. I've never seen this situation before. It's like we are hiding behind ourselves.
Who's that, Mr. Who's that?
What? Why are we this colour?
I have no idea, Mr. Duncan. You're the techno wizard.
Yes, well, what? You are talking in a very strange way today.
Maybe this is how it's going to be from now. I think you've done it deliberately, Mr. Duncan. I think this is the new effect.
Wait there, Steve.
It's a new effect that you
this
have.
Is, okay, this is not a new effect. I have absolutely no idea what's going on. I really don't know.
This is the real me talking now, the real me.
I have no idea what this is, what's going on here. No idea. Let me just see if I can make a slight change. So, Mr. Steve, you are on. You are not on camera at the moment.
Well, who knows?
Well, you're not.
Well, hopefully you can all hear us at home. Mr. Duncan is going over to his camera to try and fix it. So, Gemini 2 did ask about Scotch eggs. And, you know, I can't even remember why they're talking about Scotch eggs. Well, it's something that that Boris Johnson keeps talking about. Scotch eggs are a type of, well, you wouldn't call it delicacy. Scotch, of course, refers to Scotland. And it's an egg that is coated in meat. It's coated in a kind of meat and breadcrumbs. So it's a combination of an egg covered in sort of meat paste.
Yes.
And then you put breadcrumbs on it so that it goes sort of a yellowy colour. And then I think you fry it then.
There it is.
There's a Scotch egg.
Yes, I found one, you see. I found a Scotch egg.
That's what was... So there we go. You can see the egg in the middle and the meat around the outside and then the breadcrumbs. And I think you sort of deep fry it. And it's a bit of a joke food in the UK because nobody really eats Scotch eggs anymore.
No.
They used to back in the 70s and 80s. But it's known... It's a bit of a joke food in the UK. It's known as being very unhealthy because the meat that coats the egg is not particularly healthy meat. It's sort of leftover bits.
Yes, it's like offal, I think.
Yes. But, I mean, they're quite tasty.
Yeah.
You can have them cold.
Mm-hmm.
Usually they're eaten cold as sort of snacks. And what they were talking about in the UK, of course, is because we've got these new lockdown rules now. If you're in a particular area, you can go to a pub and you can have a drink, but only if you have what they call a substantial meal.
Steve?
Yes.
The whole thing's broken now.
So can nobody hear us or anything?
It's all crashed. I don't know why, but...
People are still writing comments.
Maybe, yes, but the vMix, unfortunately, now no longer works. So I don't know what's actually...
Can anyone hear us?
Well, we can't really carry on like this, unfortunately. What we have to do is close down and restart everything. I don't know what this is. This is very unusual. Just everything is locked up.
Yes, we can hear you, says Art.
Yes, that's that that's not really the
that's
the,
good then the so you say what you're going to do, Mr Duncan.
Yes.
And I think we're going to have to
We have to stop the live stream, unfortunately,
and restart it because something's gone wrong with the technology.
Yes, we've got to restart everything, unfortunately.
Yeah, so let me just we'll continue the story. Stay with us, we'll be back in a few minutes.
Yes.
When Mr Duncan has sorted out, but we're going to have to close it down and restart again.
Okay.
So, see you in a few minutes.
Okay, then. This is very unusual. I don't even think it's going to stop. I'm going to have to just unplug this out of the wall. Weird. How strange. Anyway, just a couple of minutes and then I will be back.